Hi, AT from CNC at home. In working with the LC-50 Plus laser, one of the things that they asked me to etch on, which kind of scared me, was stainless steel. I've worked a little bit with metal with a different laser and had really bad luck. I wasn't able to etch the metal at all, so I'm thinking stainless steel isn't going to work. It's shiny. It just, who knows what's going to happen. Well, I put it in the laser and was pleasantly surprised. We'll take a look at that. I also wanted to see if the rotary roller would work with the LC-50 Plus. And it does. I assumed it would after just a brief look at the controller, how everything was set up. I was confident that it was going to work. I just needed to get it set to the right height, and I was able to do that. I was able to put a cardboard tube in there and do some etching on it and also some cutting through it. Yeah, we'll take a look at that as well. A lot of fun playing around with this LC-50 Plus. I look forward to doing a lot more with it. It's more versatile than the LE-5040 that we've had in the past. We still have that, and we've made some modifications to it to make it better, but not quite as good as this LC-50 Plus. If you like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up. And let's get over to the laser and see how that's working. As with any new material, I wasn't sure what parameter to start with, what speed, what power. I started at 80% power at 400 millimeters per minute, and it actually did something. I was very surprised. It did a really good job even. I did several more tests, and I ended up finding that about 300 millimeters per minute at 80% power did a pretty good job of etching on the stainless steel. I was amazed that it did so well. My expectations had been pretty low when I started this project, and was very, very surprised how well it worked. I wanted to do something more than just letters and just perimeter, so I wanted to do a picture, and I used a cross hatch to fill it, where it does diagonal lines at 45 degrees and then 90 degrees to that. What I found, if you look at the arrow, is the metal started to bend as I heated it up. So it was adding and removing internal tension in the material and causing it to warp. And it was so high that it caught the protective shield in front of the laser. You can see it get moved here. That caused the engraving to be off. We'll take a close look here. We'll see that the outlining for my crosshatch and the letter K as an example just doesn't match, and that's because it got moved during the bending process. Now, the metal warped, and we can really see that here when we turn it sideways. That should be sitting flat on business card case. Here we can see how far that actually got moved from getting bumped. We also see how well the crosshatching looks when it's in the right spot. So this is a thumbs up. We know that this is viable and something that we can do in the future. We can do some more stainless steel. Now I raised the laser up on the provided extension legs. It adds another 35 millimeters to the height of the machine. I wanted to put the rotary roller in here and see how that worked with the new machine. What I found was that wasn't anywhere close to high enough. We'll see here, I'll push this tube over so you can see how little room there is. It needs to come up quite a bit more. So I put some blocks underneath the feet to raise the whole laser machine up higher so that I could do some tests on here. I did my normal frame to make sure that I wasn't going too far left or right, and I needed to set my parameters not only for burning the tube or cutting through the tube, but also for the rotary roller to make sure that it was working properly. One of the downsides of a rotary roller is a light tube such as this will slip. And I normally put two or three AA batteries inside of a tube to give it some weight. And I did for these test burns, and when I did my final burn here, forgot to put them in. But that's okay, this is just for fun, this is for testing. And I cut all the way through the material so these letters ended up being able to pop out. As I do go back and forth, the tube does slip a little bit in the positioning, and the letters at the bottom, you can really see it end up not lining up properly. You'll see this at the end. It's not a good practice with a rotary roller anyway to go back and forth because of that slipping action. So it's typically not recommended. Putting some weight in there or having a heavier object minimizes that slipping, and your burn or your cut will come out much nicer. That's why I put those AA batteries inside typically. That gives me the extra weight to hold it down and it has less slipping. As it comes over and finishes off the L, you can see how much it's moved down, and the same with the C. It really has moved down quite a bit, but not a big deal. That's something that I know about. I also wanted to try etching on the tube. The nice thing about this is there's not the back and forth. It's in the Y axis. It's back and forth in the X and very slow movement in the Y, and that leads to a much nicer burn, as we can see here. The rotary roller worked great. It works just like it's supposed to. It was able to etch on the tube, and we were able to cut through the tube. And so that was kind of fun, something I hadn't done before. So as we saw, cutting the stainless steel, the shiny stainless steel, worked really well. Just need to take care of the power settings and the speed and how much I'm cutting in one spot so it doesn't warp and bend. That's something to keep in mind. I'm pleasantly surprised at how well that worked. The rotary roller worked as well as it usually does. If I had put some weight inside of my tube, that might have helped keep it aligned a little bit better. Just a little mental lapse on my side. It's great that the LC-50 Plus works with the rotary roller. It works with stainless steel. I'm happy. It opens up some doors to more projects. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.